Let's continue the thought procedure from the last video using two very simple parts in the drill press, a flat washer and the column. These are simple parts, so let's show simple but educational ways to model them. Let's start with expressions for the washer so we can create a family of parts. For the washer, we want to have an ID, an OD, and a thickness. We can revolve a rectangle. An advantage of this method is that the three dimensions are visible on the same sketch. The entire design intent can be edited in one place. A technique I show here is to sketch on one side of the axis and mirror it so that the sketch shows diameters instead of radii. To make my intent clear, I convert the mirrored curves to reference curves. When I revolve the sketch, I select the region using the curve rule of region boundary curves, and I select the z-axis as the revolve axis. Because this part is so simple, let's model this part with a sketch of two circles and an extrude feature. Again, I can use the expressions for ID and OD in the sketch. But when I extrude the sketch, I enter the thickness expression as the end limit instead of just entering the numeric value. A tip to remember here is that when you enter an expression in a dialog box, dialog memory remembers this value, actually the expression. So the next time you use the same dialog box, remember to either convert this entry to a constant or just reset the dialog box at the top. These two parts are actually topologically the same. I can modify the dimensions of the washer to create the drill press column. But should they be modeled the same way? You size a washer by its inner diameter, but for a tube, we want its outer diameter and wall thickness. The tube also has a length. So let's change the expressions to show the design intent for a tube. This time, I only sketch one circle for the outer diameter. I use a two-sided offset on the extrude to enter the wall thickness. For the tube, let's add a chamfer to both ends. I keep the model simple by selecting both edges in the same feature. To summarize, we followed the same outline presented in the last video for a feature order, but ended up with a very different result for the washer than the tube because the design intent is different. To capture this design intent, I created expressions in each case. I also showed a technique of using reference curves to show the diameter of the revolve in the sketch. And because I used the offset extrude option, I only had to sketch half as many circles.